每一年呢 DFC 全世界有70几个国家都会有大概30到40个国家的伙伴带着自己的国家里面参与 DFC 挑战的孩子们齐聚一堂，在这个舞台上呢分享他们自己的故事，中间面临的挑战，中间的趣事，然后让彼此有一些激荡一些火花这样子。那这样子的活动我们叫它全球年会，但是遇到高峰会的时候呢就代表哇今年的活动特别盛大。在这个印度的今年的这个年会里面呢，我们就可以看到40个来自于全世界各个地方的国家的孩子伙伴，然后一起来响应参与这个盛会。 DFC 呢它的全名叫做 Design for Change， 它总共呢有4个步骤，它是一个学习法，有感受、想象、实践、分享4个步骤。这个4个步骤背后的来源呢是设计思考，那我们也相信孩子们呢能够透过这4个步骤的这个应用，在教育现场看到自己的多元潜能。那 DFC 台湾团队呢，台湾童心创意行动协会是现在目前在台湾唯一一个官方授权在推动 DFC 学习法这样的组织。
I think for me when I started Design for Change in 2009 I thought it'll just be in India. Fine, no problem, we'll roll it out in India. And then TED happened. And I think you were one of the first ones. I'm sure many people saw it, but you were the first one who sent me an email.And I was thinking, oh my God, somebody has seen my story in Taiwan and they want to do it. And I think the fact that somebody like you reached out meant that I saw the potential of it going global. And it's because of you, my dear, we're now in 70 countries.
Okay, the first group of the things that you will...
DFC 台湾团队呢，其实已经在全世界的这个伙伴的组织里面走的算是比较前面的、在推动的过程当中，它已经跳脱了只是一个 DFC 的挑战，我们慢慢的在看教育现场 DFC 学习法能够再造成怎么样更深层的改变。我们现在也是 DFC 国际的伙伴团队里面种子学校跟种子教师的系统性的推动的第一个国家。
The awareness that they've been able to generate has resulted in major impact throughout Taiwan. Their awareness campaigns, the tools and resources that they've built from their platforms to their training, they have clearly inspired an entire global network of partners in doing this work and are certainly leaders in change. So we hope that they'll continue to do this great work.
You know, when you had the BTC in Taiwan in 2018, that was epic. I mean, you know, I'll never forget that. It was an unforgettable experience with so many students taking part. And there's just so much energy that DFC Taiwan brings, you know, to the whole DFC global family.
I think Taiwan plays a very, very strong role. They're responding to the needs of the children in Taiwan. But more importantly, showing the network what's possible. So a network partner who's new is seeing the 10 years, saying, ah, okay, I can start 2 years with this, and then I can take the you know, bigger phase of doing schools and teacher training.
DFC 台湾团队呢，这一次在高峰会的现场哦，我们分成两个，一个部分呢是带着台湾的我们研发的这个教具哦，特别是永续的这个日日挑战的教具，跟全世界的伙伴分享。我们分享的关键点哦，其实是因为发现大家不管是哪一个国家的教育伙伴，其实都非常喜欢看到这个 DFC 这个概念能不能够跟其他的概念做结合，例如跟永续这个概念做结合。那因此呢，当我们今年把教具拿出来的时候，一致获得全世界伙伴的这个赞扬跟经验这样子。那我们今年还做了第二个创举哦，就是我们把我们的老师带来交流会的这个现场呢，跟更多的国际伙伴呢做更深度的交流，来看看哎 DFC 学习法能够怎么样让大家在带回教学现场的时候做更好的运用，也有更多的想象。
我觉得他们一开始对于来印度是期待，但是又有一点紧张，然后还有他们会担心他们要怎么样去 跟别人沟通，对，然后但是我觉得他们就是来，他就把它当成很新鲜的事情，后来就比较开放，而且我后来就看到他们昨天晚上会跟小孩，其他国家小孩玩在一起，对，我觉得那个语言的隔阂就消失了。
哇，我觉得每一年带着台湾的孩子上这个国际舞台都是最紧张最开心的一件事情，看到他们在台上用着练习很久的英文把自己的这个心情跟心路历程分享出来的时候，那个眼泪真的都会很想掉下来，会觉得哇好感动，然后孩子们真的做到了，那也同样的让台湾的这个教育的创新的力量让世界看见。